All right, so I'm going to start off by apologizing because this week is kind of a shorter, well, not really short, I guess, in length, but there's not as many videos for this week. I forgot to bring my video camera along for some stuff. I apologize. What I did bring along for, though, is a couple of fun things. We found out there was another free day in town. You saw before how we went to Denny's for free Grand Slams. This time we went to IHOP for free short stacks. So, see that. Also, did some coloring. What else did I do this week? Watched a lot more Olympics. And I also am going to let you into a bit of my culture, I guess, through the intercultural communications class. I will explain that later. All right, so I just finished watching the Canada-US hockey game. For those of you who didn't watch it, America won 5-3. And in true Canadian form, I'm not going to complain about the game. It was a great game. It was very exciting. Sorry, I'm going to talk about hockey for a bit. So if you don't like it, just skip this part. I'm thinking this is good. Canada won't start Brodeur anymore. I love Marty Brodeur. I have a great respect for him. He's kind of getting old. I'm just hoping that we can kind of move past that and step up our defense, hopefully. We got a lot of great defensemen on our team, and like Chris Pronger, we got Scott Niedermayer. Like, we're up there. Oh, actually, they're showing highlights right now. Right here. Sid the Kid. There's the high-paced game. There's that empty net goal. So, I mean, that is obviously, it was a lot closer of a game than it sounds, but anyways, so right now I'm trying to distract myself. I've got linear algebra here. I got some homework I gotta do there, but then also I do have the Olympics on. I've got music on. I've got Hulu going. So really, I'm just trying to move past this and get my work done, because it was just the preliminaries. It really only affects ranking, so. Whatever. We'll get it next time. Big ups, Canada.
All right, so I'm kind of addicted to Bejeweled Blitz right now. It takes over a lot of my spare time, and it's obviously a great game, but man, I waste my time playing this.
Hey everyone, it is Monday at 12:20. And I don't have class for another 2 hours. So, one thing that I love to do that you guys haven't really seen me do because I don't videotape it ever is nap.
This couch is just wonderful to sleep on. So, obviously, I love napping here. Gonna go set an alarm on the phone. Ugh. Already set. So, in 2 hours, I'll be waking up for a class. Until then, I'm sleeping. So, this little special on NBC is trying to explain. Oh, man, that is zoomed in. It's trying to explain ice dancing to me. I just don't get it. I don't understand what the difference between ice dancing and figure skating is. Except that in ice dancing, they don't jump. So, to me, that kind of removes a lot of the athleticism. I mean, why is that fun to watch?
All right, it's been a long day. And right now, I am heading to the computer lab. Why is that, you say? Well, I'll tell you why. I am meeting up with a friend of mine, Eric, who you may have seen at the auto show. Maybe I'll show him to you, let him say hi. But he's in a class on intercultural communication. And seeing as I am technically an international student, being from Canada, I'm on a list of students that is intercultural. And so he gets to meet with me throughout the semester and talk about cultural differences between the US and Canada. I'm looking forward to it. It should be fun hangout time. I don't get to hang out with Eric too much, so hopefully it'll be good friend hangout. Oh, there we go.
Also, oh my gosh, you may have seen some snow just fall through. There is snow falling everywhere here, just falling from the trees. Like it's, I don't know, like it's falling. Like that that fable where the sky fell, but it didn't, but it's actually is falling. So, snow's melting, I guess, does that mean? I'm not sure. Hopefully. I'm all right with it becoming spring soon.
Are you really gonna videotape this
though? For some of it, yeah. I mean, I'm not gonna use all of it.
Okay.
If something funny happens, I'll use that.
So, I see that you're dressed in your native Canadian garb. That's nice, yeah.
This is it. Jeans and a sweater. And a thermal.
It's pretty, very pretty.
Alright, so here I'm supposed to be ranking these in order of importance. This first column is from mine, and the second column is from importance in my culture. So, basically I get to speak on behalf of entire Canadians and say, what do we think is important? Here are the options. Alrighty. Let's get at this.
So, Peter Keep, what would you say are Jesse. Some differences between American culture and Canadian culture?
I'm trying to think of something really clever right now, and it's really not working. I'm trying to make a joke for you guys, because I like to think that I'm funny, but I'm not today. I'd say like the biggest thing is like political setups. I don't know. What else? I mean, the way we talk. I say oot and a boot and a boot. And I say, how have you been? And I say, sorry about that, eh? Instead of out and about in a boat, and how you been? And sorry, but, and not, no, I don't even think Americans apologize, really, do they? I don't think they really say sorry.
I'm sorry for
not sorry. Apologizing.
Is it true that Canadians think that Americans always say, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, really? I'd say that that's true. When we talk about you guys, yeah. Well, because, like, we try and
envision what life would be like without saying A. Like, well, because a lot of the times we'll be like, oh, that's crazy, eh? Or like, oh, sorry about that, eh? Like, it's always just kind of tagged on at the end of a sentence. We just assume that you guys would say something like, huh?
That makes sense.
I mean, and I mean, if you look at, like, the way that the words are derived, they're just kind of noises, like grunts, you know? So, they come from the same origin. I'm making all this up. I have no idea.
So, we're going to IHOP for free pancakes!
And I'm excited!
And Laura's never been to IHOP before.
Ever.
First timer.
Woohoo! It's always good to not spend money on your first time. That's what I hear, at least.
That's true.
Anyways, we'll fill you in as we go. Right now, we're just driving.
And we have to hurry, because it ends in 10 minutes.
Yeah, so...
Why are you speeding?
Julie is driving very responsibly. So, how did everyone like their free pancakes?
Oh, they were delicious! They were so good. Yummy.
Eric Robert!
Oh!
You know.
The butter pecan syrup was excellent.
Doubt it. I wanted to get a light. Why did I follow Eric?
I don't know. You can pass him. Let's pass him.
Ooh, exciting. I'm so cool.
Julie, pass him.
No, no. Pass him!
Yeah! Did you like your pancakes?
So I was just coming to put my coat away after free pancakes, and I saw this on my the wall outside. PK, love you lots. You make my heart sing. Love me. I have no idea who that is, but needless to say, it makes me feel good about myself, and that's cool with me. And that was my week. So yeah, it's pretty great. I'm looking forward to next week. Hopefully I'll remember to bring my camera along. As you can see, I'm wearing my traditional Canadian garb. Most of that stuff happened today and yesterday and the day before. I was pretty bad with bringing my video camera around for the first half of the week, so I promise to do better this week. Don't stop watching just because I failed you on this one. I promise to do better. I will see you guys next week. Continue watching, and I will be more fun. God bless.